First, Penn State, now child sex abuse allegations engulfing Syracuse University. Assistant basketball coach Bernie Fine is out of a job, fired after a third man came forward to say that Fine molested him. Now, in the Penn State case, it's not clear what Jerry Sandusky's wife knew about his behavior, but Fine's wife appears to have known what was going on at Syracuse. I want to bring in Darlene Ellison in Dallas. Her book is The Predator Next Door. She has a column in the Daily Beast explaining how pedophiles can keep their wives in the dark. So, first of all, thank you for speaking out. I know that this has been difficult for you, but you've written about it, you've talked about it. How was it in your own situation that your husband of 10 years, now your ex-husband, was able to hide his predatory behavior, his sexual abuse of boys, before the FBI brought him down?
Well, in our case, most of the abuses that did occur were not under our roof. He had compartmentalized the entire situation. So he'd set up this perfect family of four, and the abuse would take place outside of the family and or in many cases outside of the country.
You say he went on trips where he was able to carry out these sexual crimes. And did he ever have access to children in your home?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he was the parent. And so, you know, our children, you know, at the time of his arrest were 8 and 10 years old. So he absolutely had access not only to our children, but to our friends' children. And which was one of the most disturbing things in hindsight.
Because you realized you had suspected that perhaps he might have abused your own children?
Well, when you go from not having any idea to an FBI agent explaining to you what your ex-husband's being arrested for, your first thought is, oh my gosh, what has he done to my children? Oh my gosh, what has he done to the children who were visiting, you know, every time they were under our roof and then, you know, later his roof, the children that he had volunteered with at you know, the Y princesses and Y guides, the children that he had volunteered with in the his church ministry work, his volunteer work, the children he had volunteered with at the school carnivals. I mean, all those things eat at you when you find out and or realize what's happening here.
Darlene, help us understand how it is that this could happen. Were there any signs in hindsight that you think about, this doesn't feel right, it doesn't sound right, this isn't making sense with what my husband is saying and telling me, and then later you find out what he actually did?
Yes and no. It's a tough question to answer. I get asked that quite a bit, as you can imagine, especially in the last 7 years. I think the hardest thing is, you know, in hindsight is 20/20, but only to a certain extent. I feel like that unless, in terms of identifying somebody unequivocally that this person is abusing children, you know, you've got to be in the room witnessing this. You've got to know that's happening. So are there red flags so that somebody is a pedophile? Absolutely. But when you look through what the red flags are, some of those red flags are the things that make somebody absolutely endearing. You know, if a man comes to a young woman and says, you know, I volunteer for this agency and that agency, you know, I love giving back to the community and I love helping children. I love mentoring. I love, you know, that's not necessarily, while that might be listed as a red flag of somebody who is a pedophile, that in and of itself doesn't necessarily make someone a pedophile. There are some wonderful men out there who volunteer with children who are not pedophiles.